Shabbat Shalom, Israel. Pastor Corey here with Brother Miguel. And, you know, just want to get this video out. You know, we had a pretty good response to video one. But what we talking about, and this is the second part title of Come Out, People of Yah, Part 2. Because there are things that are being perpetuated as lies. And I want to make sure that as we, you know, continue in the things that we should continue in being sons and daughters of the Most High Yah, that we don't get caught up in. Because, you know, I find it very interesting, Brother Miguel, that us coming into this truth. Now, look at this clown, this G-man. I don't know what he after with Pastor Dow. I don't know what he trying to do. Mm-hmm. But he a damn fool.
For sure.
You know, especially behind the scene, you know, behind the camera, you know. And ain't anybody got time for all of that, man. You know, we trying to get truth out. It's up to you. If you think that somebody is lying pertaining to a particular subject, it's up to you to expose the lie and make what has been told now be presented as truth. And there's nobody that I know of that won't receive truth and do it. You know, those that are among us.
That's right.
You know, I don't know what other people do. I'm not on the corner cursing folks out. I'm not a part of any of these other camps. But merely, you know, it's just an attempt for us to continue to forge what's true and get people's minds to begin to focus in on the things that's necessary as, you know, we go through this life. It's necessary for us to find the path of righteousness and expose lies and, you know, turn away from them.
Yes, sir.
So, you know, I want to welcome you all back to this part where in this video, you know, we are exposing how, you know, we continue to live by lies and people accept lies. They accept lies in their life. They don't look into them. They don't worry about they live in the lie, even if they know. You know, I had a conversation with one of my parents yesterday. You know, we was just talking. He said, you know, what did you guys do for Thanksgiving? I said, well, I didn't do anything Thanksgiving.
Right.
But I smoked a couple of turkeys because, you know, I got them free, right. You know. And, you know, just wanted to really take time with my boys where we sat around and we talked about lies.
Yes, sir.
Like, you know, the things that, you know, from when I first started looking at the likes of slavery, you know, because I was showing them the other day, because people want you to hurry up and forget.
They want to erase it.
They want to erase it. That's what they want to do. And then here's the thing about it with slavery. We know, yes, it was the forefathers of America that did this. And we know that, you know, today there's a better attempt to treat all people equal and so on and so on. But that ain't the case.
No.
That ain't the case. It's a lot of hidden things that pertain to race, that pertain to being black or white. Mm-hmm. You know, I look at all the uprising behind Black Lives Matter. Now, I don't totally know what the organization stand for, but we see Blue Lives Matter, White Lives Matter, and all this other crap where there has never really been an acknowledgement to the atrocity that have gone on with those who have been in slavery. And in fact, the information keep changing. Mm-hmm. You know, you look where it used to all over the internet. Almost 6-7 years ago, they used to have where you can find information about 400 years of slavery.
Mm-hmm.
But since people been able to point that out in the Bible, then they started changing it, making it 200 some years. And,
changing, you know, the textbooks.
Oh,
too.
Man, changing the textbooks. I mean, you know, I matter of fact, you're right. I heard that there was a textbook down in Texas where they changed slavery, being that we were indentured. Boy, if that ain't the biggest bull crap, man, that you can hear, man, I don't know what. So, our video today is going to point out a few things, but before we get into it, I'm going to finish sharing the story. When I was talking to the parent yesterday at the gym, and I was just telling them, I said, you know, the thing about me teaching my boys truth is that there won't ever be a time where my boys can say that I taught them lies, mm-hmm. that I taught them things that was incorrect. So this is what I said. I asked him, I said, did you know that Thanksgiving was associated with the day of mourning? And he was like, what do you mean? I said, well, you know, there's things that have been said about Native Americans or the indigenous people that was in this land, you know, and in fact, I'm going to include, you know, a few videos where, you know, we're going to see in the midst of this video where there's going to be a few clips from a few things that we're talking about that really expose the lies that we live.
Presenting Marlon Brando this evening, and he has asked me to tell you that he very regretfully cannot accept this very generous award. And the reasons for this being are the treatment of American Indians today by the film industry. Excuse me. I beg you will meet with love and generosity. Thank you on behalf of Marlon Brando.
Tell me then, way back when you registered in Indians' fishing rights, before it was fashionable to be so, what triggered that?
What we've learned about the Indians has been largely taught to us by Hollywood and by motion pictures, seeing Indians represented as savage, as ugly, as nasty, vicious. Everything we are taught about the American Indian is wrong. There have been 400 treaties written by the United States in good faith with the Indians, and every single one of them was broken. We like to see ourselves as perhaps John Wayne sees us, that we are a country that stands for freedom, for rightness, for justice. It just simply doesn't apply. And we were the most rapacious, aggressive, destructive, torturing, monstrous people who swept from one coast to the other, murdering and causing mayhem among the Indians. There's one Indian in there.
One, you know, they talked about how, you know, they changed the color of the indigenous people.
Right. Yes, sir.
You know, people didn't even know that blacks, you know, because they whited it out, they faded it out, changed it out, whatever else you can do to get it out, they've done that.
Yes, sir.
So that we don't know the truth.
And as you know, in April, we announced that we were reviewing our position on the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. And today I can announce that the United States is lending its support to this declaration.
We the people.
Hello, this is Patrick with New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel. Just taking my mountain bike along some of the trails here in Tinton Falls, New Jersey. And someone had mentioned this to me earlier, that there was almost like an abandoned cemetery called Shadows Rest off of Ruffin Court in Tinton Falls. It's closer to the border of Colts Neck.
This is just one of my family's burial grounds, which has been falsely recorded in history as an African-American cemetery.
believe this was one of the first African-American graveyards or cemeteries in the area.
We still here. We never left.
Because of all the thousands of people that I've met over my years, conversations with people that look like African-American people. And when you really get down to the nit and the grit of it and ask them, what's your ancestry? Oh, my grandma was a Cherokee, or my great-great-grandfather was, I think he was a Seminole. And because of the stolen heritage of American Indians with black blood and black people with Indian blood, I felt that it was time that black folks of Indian blood and Indian folks with black blood were able to come together as a people and not feel ridiculed, marginalized, or subjugated because they stood up and told the world who they are.
Come out your shells, turtles. The world's waiting.
Their mahogany skin shown through.
They know who we are. Ain't no need to argue with them.
These dark angels would make exceptional wives for the English planters, and their dark skin would bleach out in two generations, unquote. That's a quote that he made.
So that was the whole goal, to try to bleach out, as they say.
Yeah, but it kind of tells you that first Americans were a rich brown people.
Mm-hmm.
They were mahogany in color.
Mama knew what she was talking about, but I always thought that she wanted to be something that we wasn't. And I remember I used to say, Mama, we black.
Other than the cultural assimilation over the years, what's more respectful, being a Negro or a black man?
You know, some of these things are just now surfacing, and it's very important. That information is very important, believe me. Has a lot to do with how we go about in this earth, because first of all, there has been a inferiority complex placed upon these people because of what you have done. You painted Jesus white. You painted the Egyptians white. You painted the Indians white. Every goddamn body is white. If it ain't a problem, tell the truth. Why? So that's what I'm saying. You go and hide slavery and change the likeness of slavery. Why don't you tell people the truth and let them decide what is good and what's right for them? Why? Because then people quit believing. And that one lie exposed in this system really exposes a bunch of lies in this system. Bold belief.
And it's now reached my hospital to where if you do not get it, you're terminated. Yes, it is against our constitutional rights. Yes, it's completely absurd, but it's coming from Obamacare. So I just came out of this meeting. I said no to my director, so it got kicked up higher up in our company, and I had to go sit down kind of like with a board of people. It wasn't really that many, but still, it was still me against them. And it was nice, and they were nice, and everything was great, and you know, they explained to me just what I already knew. This is coming down from the government. 90% of the employees have to be vaccinated or they do not get paid Medicare and Medicaid payments. We are the guinea pigs. And as I was talking to them, first of all, I want you guys to know, there is no way to make a vaccine for the flu. It's not possible. The flu is a RNA replicating virus. Because it replicates RNA, it is sloppy with it, and it never replicates itself the same way. Every single time it multiplies, it changes itself. And the CDC, the scientists, biologists, there is no tracking this down. Every single season, every single time you get the flu, it's different from the last time you got the flu. Hopefully you never get it. I hopefully you don't. But here they are pressing a vaccine that is impossible to make a vaccine, the flu, impossible to make, with massive amounts of detergents and preservatives. You've got flu ad that's being pushed this year for 2015-2016. It's got 14 different crazy things in it. So not only are you fighting three live viruses that no longer exist, you're having to fight crazy detergents and astringents just to keep this virus alive and preserved. Then they give me an insert. They said, okay, you know, we understand. And I feel bad for them because these are people just like you and me who put on their pants, who go to work, who have to put food on their table, who have kids. I felt compassion in there. Must have been from the Lord. I really did. There really wasn't any anger. I felt more of compassion because I'm not the only person they're having to talk to about this. This is happening every single day since September the 1st, since they announced this mandatory vaccination. I felt compassion because as they were... I could have sworn I saw tears welling up in somebody's eyes when they say, I lay in bed at night, I stare at the walls, I understand, you know, people's livelihoods are at stake here. I'm telling them that they can't have their freedom, that they have to be injected or else. He's like, I can't stand being that way. He's like, I've never taken the flu shot in my life, but I took it for the first time this year just for the same reason. He's like, I don't want you to think that some people are some magic word you can say that you can't take it and others don't take it. He said, we're all under this together. And this goes back to an earlier video that I made earlier with everything just gonna be okay and make America great again. How is that when everyone is losing their jobs because they won't accept communism? So they give me this insert. He says, I want to give you more options. You know, here's some options. Here's flu ad. And I said, well, do you have flu block is another vaccine that is supposed to be organic. It doesn't have as many astringents or detergents in it. And I said, well, let me look it over. I'm open-minded to everything. Just let me look at it and let me read what's inside of it. I'm reading what's inside of flu block, and it's a genetically modified organism vaccine out of the proteins of insects. Not to mention, it's got, instead of 14 detergents and astringents, it's got about right under 10. It's not any better. And it still has the same side effects as the rest of the vaccine.
You know, even with the schools, there's another clip I'm gonna put in here where I work in an alternative school. And the clip you're gonna see, I've seen it actually with my own eyes happen in them alternative schools where the children was just absolutely nuts. And I'm like, you know, how do something like this even exist on this earth where we supposed to be bettering humanity? We supposed to be bettering the citizens that come out to the society. But it's a whole big hoax going on.
No, fuck that! I told your ass!
Situation.
Like a
cock. How do you feel? How are you feeling about this?
I need you to throw your whatever you're throwing. I need you to throw them away. Okay, then later I'm gonna have to ask you to have a seat.
You're on candid.
No, Chloe.
I'm finna smack ass with a whole bag of Emily.
Do it. There was no history being told. There was nothing to combat that other than someone telling me, don't do it. We don't do that.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm thankful, Pastor. I'm grateful because children get to see it. Not only that, my children can tell you out of their mouths what Thanksgiving is about. They can tell you out of their mouths what Christmas is about, what Halloween is about. And they'll tell you it's wicked. They'll tell you it's wicked straight up. Adults, children, it don't even matter. They'll walk in the store and point out like, that's wicked. They not all and moved by all these bright lights and colors. They not all and moved by the candy and gifts. They understand what vanity is, man. And that's the beautiful thing about walking in the ways of the Most High Yah, because you learn to appreciate and live according to how He wants us to live. See, it's wisdom in the ways of Yah. It's wisdom in that. You understand what I'm saying? Because you walking in that, you're not going to, those things aren't going to appeal to you the same way they appeal to people that don't walk in the ways of the Most High, yeah. His wisdom and everything he does. So, Pastor, yeah, I mean, our children, these seeds that we're raising up, they're going to know.
Exactly.
They're going to know the whole truth.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't nobody going to be able to come and deceive them with some type of doctrine or, you know, just do it. You don't have to worship. No, anytime you offering up these meats, anytime you in any type of commune with these people, you are partaking in it. Mm-hmm. You're partaking in it. Just dry cut, you're partaking in it.
You know, here's one thing I want to point out about it, you know, that I really wanted to get to, you know, concerning the indigenous people, because here it is all across the landmass of America. You know, like I was telling him, I said, with America, there's, you know, two facets working. You got the United States of America,
mm-hmm.
corporation.
Right.
Then you have the United States, the landmass of states yeah. that started with the 13 colonies who came into pact and agreement with one another.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And knowing that they also know the truth, because in the agreements of the Constitution and the articles of the Constitution and the amendments, there's a lot of verbiage in there that reflect that this land belongs to the indigenous people, but yes. we know it. And at any time, they can act as indigenous people
yeah.
and be a separate sovereign, not unequal to, equal to.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
And so in knowing that, then that's what I'm saying. You know, we keep Thanksgiving not knowing that the celebration that you have was to take away the landmass that the indigenous people had owned. And you robbed them of simplicities, where really start, you know, like I said, getting an understanding of these things and being a indigenous person, you enjoy the simplicities of life that the Most High Yah gave you.
That's right.
Fishing, hunting, that's right?
Right. Mm-hmm.
Family. You know, doing right between brother, between tribe, between clan. You know, not doing any injustices among each other. But these folks are not built up like that.
Not at all.
And I heard, you know, and it's another video that I did download that you hear out of the mouth of a white individual who was talking about how the United States have made treaty after treaty after treaty after treaty and broken all of them.
Yes, sir. Broken all of them. That's how they do. They're criminals, man. They're just criminals. And they do it in such a sneaky and crafty way so that they make us look like we're the criminals.
Exactly.
Because we are receiving or walking in what we're supposed to be walking in.
Exactly.
Because we want to homeschool. You know what I mean? Because we do these things and don't partake in what they do. They want to ostracize us.
Yeah.
When they're the ones that have been deceitful. They're the ones that have came and killed and plundered mm-hmm. and raped. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Did all these things.
Right.
For greedy gain.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's man, Pastor, it's
something else. Oh, it is. It is. And I look at just how, you know, just me coming out of that thought process, how I'm able now to, as I uncover lies, how it frees my mind where I don't have no quorum with living free from the lies. See, people say, they point at you like, oh, these the people that want to live way away from everybody. Where the Bible is saying, when you got Public Law 97-280 saying that the Bible is the word of Yah, the word of God,
yes,
then
sir.
You find in there that the Bible instruct for you to come out among them and be ye separate. Why? Because you got ways that are simplistic that the Most High value in you, because it allows you to continue in relationship with him, because he is the one that bring increase in your life. In their life, they bring the increase in their own lives. And so when you look at how much bullcrap is surrounding all of these things, well, you want people to live lives. You want people to be slaves. You want to continue to get rich on the backs of other people. And it's a horrible thing. And this is where you got to wake up. This is where you got to come out of the lies. You got to come out. If you belong to the Most High God, you don't belong among these people living lies. You don't belong there. That's where the passion come in at. I'm going to read something to you right here. Let me read something to you really quick here.
That's it, Pastor.
You got Revelation 11, 18. I want you to open up to that. I'm going to read the First Amendment to you. And I want you to listen to this. This says, Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. The free exercise thereof. Or abridging the freedom of speech or of the press or the right of the people to peaceably assemble and to petition the government for a redress of grievances. Well, the point here is they shall not make a law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise. So guess what? We are Israel. We found out we Israel. But you want to now classify us as a IBOE or whatever this bull crap is that you're trying to label us as some type of terrorist group.
Extremists, yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, and you know, that's what I'm talking about, where you trying to afflict on the minds of the people some type of lies to perpetuate that we are off our, we're off our rockers, we're out of our minds, we have gone mad. We got some type of psychological problem where it's clear. See, I'm going to tell you this. The difference between a 501c3 organization and a 508-1A is a 508-1A is as a free church, meaning the government should have no part in it. No way, shape, form, or fashion. No jurisdiction at all. No. I'm just giving you some history, some background. We're not either one. Neither one. But I'm just telling you how things work. And a 501c3 is counted as a charitable organization where the government can regulate. Yep. The government can regulate. The government, here it is in the amendment that we just read, where the government should have no part in it. But they got a part in it when you're a 501c3. I want you to think about that. See, because in knowing that and being a true believer, this is where you got to stand. See, I'm going to prove it to you. You heard of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego according to the names that they gave them in Babylon. And they stood up. Daniel.
Yes, sir.
Stood up.
Firm.
Firm.
Joseph. Yes, stood sir. Up. So, what we got to understand that it's given to us to stand up. Did I say go start uprisings? I didn't say start an uprising. But don't be a pushover. Don't be a passive punk sitting in your house scared as hell to live righteously because of what somebody else think. And so that's where this is different than Christianity. This is where this is different, because we are finding out the true ways of the Most High Yah, and we are those to restore.
That's right.
Regardless of what people say, regardless of what you think, and we're not going to stop. We're going to continue in our path. And when they bring the destructions that they want to bring upon people, ain't no fear.
None.
Ain't no fear, brother, because I know this is the right way to go when you got people. Here it is. People find out that it's a lie. You go search behind this stuff with Christmas, Halloween, Thanksgiving and Easter, and you find out it's a lie, and you continue in it? I mean, ain't nothing to say. I want you to hear one more thing right here. This is Article 1 of the Declaration of Rights. Section 11, religious freedom. Absolute freedom of conscience in all matters of religious sentiment, belief, and worship shall be guaranteed to every individual, and no one shall be molested or disturbed in person or property on account of religion, but the liberty of conscience hereby secured shall not be so construed as to excuse acts of licentiousness or justify practices inconsistent with the peace and safety of that state. Look at this. But there's a great underlying move to get people not to wake up.
Yes, sir. And that's what they do. They give these articles, they give these what I would call kind of like sanctions, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But then they come behind that with a plan already to infiltrate whatever you may be trying. If you're trying to take advantage of that, they already got something set up for you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's not mentioned in there.
Mm-hmm.
So they look for any type of opening. It's like, okay, we'll put this out, but if they're going to do this, let's have a law right here. Let's have a mandate right here that's not going to allow them to fully move and operate in that.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
You know what I mean? So, yep. They, I mean, they saw crafty counsel. They're very wise in everything that they do.
I want y'all to hear something in Revelation 11:18. I want y'all to hear this. Read that, brother, again.
And the nations were angry, and thy wrath is come, and the time of the dead, that they should be judged, and that thou shouldest give reward unto thy servants, the prophets, and to the saints, and them that fear thy name, small and great, and shouldest destroy them which destroy the earth.
Now you hear that? It said, and shall destroy them which destroy the earth. Now we know that's the Gentiles destroying the earth, brother.
Yes, sir.
They destroying it by what they doing to the food. They destroying it because they changing the natural construct. You got to have licenses to go fishing. You got to have license to go hunting. You have a license to do everything that the Most High said you do in natural law.
Yes, sir.
In natural law, I don't need your damn hand to go find me some damn food.
Everything. They regulate everything. That's been the plan. That's been the plan. Control.
That's it. And that's what you trying to do. That's how you trying to bring everybody into some type of slavery and bondage to your will and your purpose, what you want to accomplish. But the Most High gonna see to it ain't gonna be. That's in Revelation 11:18. He said he gonna destroy them that destroyed the earth, and that's exactly what you doing. Go ahead, brother.
No, I was just thinking, Pastor, you know, we have no issue with conforming to the rules and regulations and guidelines of this world, of this earth. You know, because that's what the masses do. But when it comes to falling underneath the banner of righteousness, underneath the statutes of the Most High Yah, I mean, it's like pulling teeth.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
It's, mm-hmm.
it's like pulling teeth, Pastor. And that's what, you know, I'd rather be in bondage to that than in bondage to this world. You understand what I'm saying?
Exactly. Yep. Well, see, what people gotta understand is that the creator of the universe, the creator of all things that's in heaven and earth, you know, he have infinite wisdom.
Yes, sir.
And in that infinite wisdom, the understanding is that submission to his way, you know, creates a life of peace, a life of tranquility, safety. I mean, it's a, you know, it's just, you can't really put into words when you begin to understand just the little wisdom and knowledge and understanding that the Most High give us. You can't put into words, because this is the freest I've ever felt in my life. I feel good because the system has no effect on us, how we live, because we found ways to make our path straight in the midst of this perverted generation.
Yes, sir.
And you know, it brings, like you said, it brings peace. I know what my kids are learning. I know what they are doing. I know what my children are doing. You know, I know what, you know, my day-to-day should consist of in how I should be living among my brothers, what Hallelujah. I should do to continue to further what it is and to be free from all of these things that other people think they're free to do. They want to be free to sin
That's
to
right.
death.
That's it. That's it. That's it. Loose cannons out here.
That's man. It.
No guidelines. There's no wisdom in it. They just out here, brother, just living and dying at the same time, man.
That's it.
No life. Hallelujah.
Well, in closure of this, you know, I want you all to make sure that, you know, you take heed because, you know, it's my job and my attempt to continue just to shed light. You know, you're going to have to go do your own due diligence like I'm doing. I'm not going to sit here and try to give you everything that you need
Bless you, Pastor.
You know to do because that's what you lazy. Yeah, that's what people are. You know, I spend time my whole day in the midst of work and everything. Whenever I get the free moments,
it's true.
I'm filling it in right here. It's true. Because this curve, this learning curve, and the bull crap that's taking place is far, far ahead than what we can ever be. And so I'm going to leave you with this. You got to understand that natural law is the highest law that can ever exist according to the Most High Yah. And that's how you should live. And so with natural law, that law allows us now to judge ourselves. That allows us to make peace among ourselves. That allows us to have freedom of speech because they have no jurisdiction in what you say among your people. I hate gay ass people.
That's it.
The person that's dwelling in that body ain't the person I hate. I hate the flesh that they dwell in because the flesh shall not inherit the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
The flesh takes on whatever lust and whatever perversions that come to it, and it do it. And if your mind is in agreement with it and your mind is not led by the Holy Spirit, then you fall into these traps and these snares of Every doing time. And fulfilling the lust of the flesh.
Every time.
And so this is what our attempt is to in coming out is to get your mind to be separate than the mind of the flesh. So the mind of the flesh is enmity against the Most High Yah, and it is death. I promise you. And so if you can hear that, if you can hear these words that we speaking to you, then guess what? I believe that you will begin to be on a path of righteousness. And you all have a blessed Sabbath. Brother McGill, I appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Bless you.
And you all continue your path and your search for truth. And you continue to seek the Most High Yah on everything that you need to receive concerning the wisdom behind what is being perpetuated today in the form of lies. And you too will come out. Hey, you all be blessed. I'm Pastor Corey.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.